decision finally made not to try for a fogey, but rather the closer village of Manari, with the hope the boys pleading to go home will improve after a good night's rest.
Well, here in Manari, population around 300 to 350 people, considered one of the bigger villages we'll visit during our trek. And in every village we strike, plenty of kids wanting to know what's going on. Say hello.
Hello.
The break has had the desired effect, with Jade back among the living. A long day and night march awaits, but the mood among the boys is good.
We learned one word last night. Goody goody wash wash.
That's a mad river crossing, man. They're good mates here. We struggle sometimes.
Just reached Brigade Hill, where 1,000 Australians defended against 6,000 Japanese. This is the burial ground where some of the Australians were buried. Natives came along, found them and buried them. And we've just walked this hill.
Perhaps you'll learn in some unknown way of that rugged little cross. The remains of a hero beneath it lay, where the trees are draped in moss. We curse the foe who stripped the dead. No mercy to them can be shown. So we marked his grave so it can be read. WX, unknown.
You pull that pin.
Oi, watch out.
It releases a fuse, which burns for about 4 seconds and then detonates the explosive.
That wouldn't detonate, which that, would it?
Yes,
yeah,
it would. Then it sends these pieces, which become shrapnel. That little piece there may fly out there and go through there, and that little bit fly out there and go through there. So these have a killing range of about 5 metres, so that if this hand grenade went off here, it would take out everybody within about a 5 metre circle, take out all of us. Okay, don't touch it.
Further down the track, the village of Afogi presents a welcome face for the trekkers.
Hello. Hello.
But everywhere, reminder the area once echoed to the sounds of a world at war.
303 belt clips,
yeah.
2-inch Japanese mortar.
Bloody amazing.
The aches and pains of the track put to one side for a runaround with the Afogi First 13 in the backyard of a piece of colonial history.
Until New Guinea gained its independence in 1975, this was the governor's residence here in the village of Afogi. And what comparative luxury. We're in the kitchen with cupboards and a sink and taps for running water. The windows have screens and glass Venetians. Through here we've got bedrooms, 1 and 2, Look down here, we've got hard wooden floors, no dirt floor for the governor. And of course out here on the veranda, no governor's residence complete without the outdoor cooking area.
But time off the track and a footy game reaps a tough reward, more night trekking.
Just because only one person's been pissed off today and it's been separated doesn't mean someone might not end up hitting you.
Destination Naduri Village appears out of the darkness at about midnight.